So there is a rate cut, I think, which has come in by 25 basis points. That's exactly what our director told us. So we'll just wait by and go to Lata for it as well. So, and the stance has changed to neutral from calibrated tightening. So this is basically the most dovish outcome. Lata is ready, so let's go across to her.
Yeah, I think it's not just that the rate has been cut. The inflation estimates have been revised very sharply lower. For the Q3 itself, it has come in at 2.6. And for the fourth quarter, originally they had estimated 2.7 to 3.2. Now the estimate has been cut to 2.8. So that's a big cut. And then for the first half of next year, the inflation forecast, originally 3.8 to 4.2. Now it is 3.2 to 3.4. No, the cut is about 60 basis points inflation forecast, and for Q3 of next year, it is 3.9. So basically, for full of calendar 2019, the Reserve Bank estimate is below 3.9 or below. And for the first half, it is, you know, below 3.5. That is substantially below the previous estimate of 4.2. So, you know, it's a very benign outlook. I would think that this indicates there are further rate cuts in the offing. And growth has been revised marginally lower. They're going by the CSO forecast of 7.2. The original GDP forecast was 7.4 for the current year. For next year, they've revised it lower by 10 basis points. So growth is unimportant. What is important is that 60 basis point lower inflation forecast revision and only 3.9 as the highest inflation number for all of 2019. So the repo cut coming from 6.5 to 6.25 indicates there is clearly more space. Also, the language of the Reserve Bank when it is talking about future inflation forecast is extremely benign. I mean, there are hardly any risks. They are not making a song and dance about fisc or about core inflation, though they mention it. The biggest risk they see is vegetable inflation could go up and oil price could remain a little elevated, or it could even go down depending on global growth. But where they talk about core inflation is, the rural education and health needs to be watched whether it is a one-off. That is one risk. And on budget, they're extremely benign. They're not looking at it as a runaway fiscal deficit. I'll read out. They say several proposals in the union budget are likely to boost aggregate demand by raising disposable income, but the full effect of some of the measures are likely to materialize only over a period of time. So the inflationary impact or aggregate demand impact of the budget measures are seen coming over time, hence no threat to inflation. My own reading is that there genuinely is more space for cut, going by what the Reserve Bank has said. I will quickly speak about two or three very important developmental measures as well. And those are that ECBs can be used even to pay up those people who are buying up the IBC cases. Also, there is no limit to FPIs investing in corporate debt. There was a limit of 20% on one corporate paper. That limit of 20% has been removed. And more than anything else, risk weight on NBFCs used to be 100%. That risk weight now is not 100%. It will depend on the rating of the paper. So those are the main announcements. Sonia, I would want you to ask what the main comments, Ekta, what are the main comments from our experts?
Yes, absolutely. And Lata, just before that, the Bank Nifty is in fact at the high point of the day. So that's rallied to a gain of around 0.5%. And maybe the yield should come up for you as well. Let's see whether there's any kind of softening which has taken place. For the Nifty also, it's
Sonia, 1 minute. Sonia, you must look at the bond yield. Yes. I think it would have jumped substantially.
Well, no, Lata.
And you may want to go to Taimur and ask him if he expects more
cuts. In fact just about flat. It's not, it's just a change of 1 basis point as of now for the bond yield. But let's in fact go across to Taimur.
So then
and
it
ask
is not then it is not updating.
Yes, so we'll try and update
Taimur,
that and get fresh
rates. What do you
rates,
make of this, more rate cuts?